Hello, good morning. We are going to talk today about general plane motion. And you learn in primary school, secondary school, that our planet is traveling around the sun, but it's also rotating with respect to its own axis. That's a sort of general motion. But when we talk about problems on the plane, for instance, rolling problems, we have things that are advancing in translation, but at the same time they are rotating, okay, like this way. With perfect traction, we can see that there's no slipping between the surfaces, and when there's non-slipping, we can relate the acceleration of the mass center with the angular acceleration, with a simple equation that we call Ag equals alpha times r. That's not the case when we have slipping, because then there will be no relation between the acceleration of the mass center and the angular acceleration of this wheel. I prepare you a simple flowchart for you to use when you have problems that involve general plane motion. And the first thing is to identify the problem as a problem of general plane motion. You will have translation and rotation at the same time. Okay? That would be problem of general plane motion. Now, as usual, you need to draw your two diagrams, the free body diagram and the kinetic diagram, where you show the inertial forces and acceleration, Ig alpha. You write the three equations of motion, as usual, and you need to remember that there's an alternative way to write the equations of moments. You can write them with respect to g, and it will be equal to Ig alpha, or with respect to p, to a different point. In that case, the right-hand side of the equation becomes the sum of kinetic moments, that is Ig alpha plus the moments produced by the inertial forces due to the acceleration of the mass center. If you have rolling problems like in this case, you need to make an assumption because you will have four unknowns. You will have the contact normal force, the friction force, the acceleration of the mass center, and the angular acceleration. So four unknowns for three equations. So how do you proceed? You need a fourth equation. That fourth equation comes from an assumption. That assumption is to assume that there's no slipping between the two surfaces. In that case, as I mentioned at the beginning, you can relate the acceleration of the mass center with the angular acceleration with the equation Ag equals alpha times r. And then you solve the equations, the three equations of motion with this fourth equation. And when you have found the answer to the unknowns, you need to check if the assumption was correct. And how do you check it? By checking the value of the friction force that is indicated in this box. The friction force can never be greater than mu s n, the static friction. So you check if the friction that was solved in the equation of motion is lower than mu s n. If that's the case, your assumption is correct, and then you can show the results and problem finished. The problem is not complete if you don't check the assumption. But what happens if the friction force is greater than mu s n? Then you need to change the assumption, and in this case, you already know that this thing is slipping, and the friction is equal to the kinetic friction. No longer this equation of Ag equals alpha times r is valid. This is not valid anymore. The fourth equation is the friction force equals mu k n. You solve again the equations, and then that will be your result. So, general plane motion is the most complete type of motion that we see in this course. It involves rotation, but at the same time, translation. So, use this flowchart to solve the problems that you have in the book and in Blackboard. And I'll see you in the next video for dynamics. Thank you very much, and see you next time.